Welcome back, fight fans. This portion of tonight's broadcast is brought to you by the Badass Pad. That's the pad you saw for the back of your motorcycle and all the advertisements, and also Taylor Auto Repair. Coming up next is our main event of the evening. It is Michael Wilkins versus Christopher Coggins. Michael Wilkins, a Henzo Gracie Jiu-Jitsu fighter, Christopher Coggins, made his way here from Tennessee. Let's take a look at the tail of the tape. Here we have Mike Wilkins, 27 years of age, 5 feet 11 inches tall, weighing in at 155 pounds with a professional record of 4 wins and 1 loss. He's taking on Chris Coggins, 25 years of age, 5 feet 9 inches tall, weighing 155 pounds with a professional record of 7 wins, 7 losses. Now to our announcer, Dan Bogan, to call in the fighters for the next event.
We need now from the red corner, Chris Coggins.
Chris Coggins making his way to the cage, getting a little slap around from his cornerman. As we said before, a lot of times guys don't want to feel the first punch of the night once they step in.
No, it's 7-7. He's an experienced professional, and I imagine there's probably a deep amateur record behind that. You know, he's been through a lot of fights, so I would expect him to, look fairly good out here tonight.
And you know something of interest? You might find this kind of interesting yourself, Mike. Christopher Coggins' last fight was a loss versus Eric Calderon via split decision. His opponent tonight, Michael Wilkins' last fight, was a win versus Eric Calderon via third round guillotine. So we have two guys that have definitively fought the same guy, two different results, both hard fought battles.
Interesting. I mean, there's always the tendency to look at things and say, well, if A beats B and B beats C, then A beats C, but that's not always the case in fighting.
There's always a variable.
Every matchup is individual.
Any man can win on any night. That's
also
MMA.
From what I've seen, both these guys actually seem to be more submission-oriented fighters. So I would expect the possibility of an advanced ground game here.
Absolutely. Let's have our ring announcer, Dan Bogan, call in the main event opponent.
Before we bring in our next fighter, I'd like to mention joining us tonight, former Gladiators of the Cage fighter, current UFC fighter, from Ambridge, Pennsylvania, Chris Dempsey. Welcome, Chris Dempsey. Thank you for joining us tonight. It's an honor. We need now from the blue corner on our main event, Mike Wilkins. Mike Wilkins, cage side.
Mike Wilkins, a lot of crowd support here.
Mike Wilkins has been on the come up, and his time is coming soon. He's had a few write-ups recently on MMA media websites. His game has been impressive. I was here to call his last fight versus Eric Calderon when he got that third round guillotine, and he snatched that guillotine after going to war for 2.5 rounds versus Calderon.
Mike Wilkins, impressive wrestling pedigree, wrestled his whole life, currently coaches high school wrestling, purple belt at Henzo Gracie. Probably pretty close to a brown belt by this point in time. Who knows, if he wins the fight, you might see a presentation tonight. I'm not calling anything, but I'm just saying, could happen.
Absolutely. Mike Wilkins, 4 win, 1 loss as a professional. He's 5 feet 11 inches tall, 2 inches higher than his opponent, Christopher Coggins, tonight. I don't know if that's gonna matter much, because I don't know if that's really what Wilkins wants to do, is stand and trade on the end of his punches.
You know, the thing about Wilkins is it's not so much just his height. He is a big 155, one of the biggest I've ever seen. I don't know how much weight he cuts to get to 55, and I don't think it's so much that it's unhealthy because he has endurance, but
maybe he's got hollow bones.
Like a bird.
Like a bird, avian bone syndrome. Let's go to our ring announcer, Dan Bogan, for the official introduction.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you're looking for high-quality, high-definition photos of tonight's fight, you can buy them from Rob Lynn Photography, Sean Eisler Photography, both doing good jobs. Check out their websites. You'll think you're Chip Snyder. He gets such good close pictures. Ladies and gentlemen, these bouts are sanctioned and approved by the Pennsylvania State Athletic Commission. Executive Director is the Honorable Craig Serb. Our Commissioner at ringside, Mr. Ron Russitano. The officials tonight, our judges, Todd Kushka, John Leksavik, and Cleveland Kevin Armstrong. your referee for each and every fight the entire evening, Mr. Chip Snyder. Physician at ringside is Dr. Lawrence Biskin, our timekeeper at the bell, Stephen the Hammer Cruz. I'm your ringer, ring announcer Dan Bogan. Give it up for our ring girls, Emma, Brittany, and Alicia this evening. This is our main event of the evening, and it's in the Gladiators of the Cage, professional lightweight division, calling for 3 5-minute rounds. When the bell rings, your referee is Chip Snyder. First, introducing out of the red corner. He weighed in at 153 pounds. He stands 5'8". His reach is 71 inches, 25 years of age. He has a 7-7 record. He fights for SSF Submission Academy. From Clarksville, Tennessee, Chris Dodgen Coggins! Chris Coggins! And his opponent in the blue corner. He weighed in at 155 pounds. He stands 5'10". He's got a 72-inch reach. 27 years of age, a 4-1 record. From Henzo Gracie, Pittsburgh. He's from Pittsburgh. Mike Wilkins! Let's get Chip Snyder's official announcements and instructions to the fighters.
You know, I don't know who it was that said it, but I heard once to always keep your eye on an opponent that claps at themselves when their name is announced.
I've just heard
that that's an indication of what might be having to come. We'll see here real soon.
We will, because it's about to start, the main event of the evening.
Both fighters looking ready. Glove touch. A lot of movement by Coggins, a lot of footwork already.
And we'll see if, this has a lot of stand up at all, or both men just really want to go to the ground.
Big, powerful kick by Coggins. Very fast movement. A lot of feinting and moving by Coggins. I like that. I like seeing that.
I think this is something you're going to see from more experienced pros, is there's going to be a little bit more feeling out process, especially guys with this kind of style. Neither of them are like bullies. They're not guys who rush out and just try to club. Oh, Wilkins landing some big leather there.
Wilkins trying to capitalize on a bit of a movement he made there.
Wilkins
big shots to the liver.
Pounding the body. Uppercuts, body, head, over and over again.
And he's got the cardio to keep this up.
Real big uppercut there.
Beautiful dirty boxing by Wilkins.
Very close to that trip. Very nice transition to that trip setup. Didn't work that time, but that was really, really nicely done.
Coggins' game plan needs to be to get a little bit of distance, a little bit of separation.
Coggins got caught there on the way in, shakes it off.
There's no doubt Christopher Coggins is a tough opponent. With 7 wins and 7 losses as a professional, he's been around the block.
He's tough, but I think the thing is here, he's going to find Wilkins' range and pretty much superior size and maybe strength to be very hard to deal with.
I think Coggins just needs to get into a rhythm, but Wilkins is not letting that happen.
No.
Oh, my. Is this going to be it?
And
can Coggins hold on?
I think this fight is very close to being stopped.
I don't know. He's protecting
Snyder.
He's intelligently defending himself. Pushing the head. Oh, and it is over.
And that is it.
Wow. Mike Wilkins pulls off the win in the first. What an amazing performance by another Henzo Gracie Jiu-Jitsu fighter here tonight.
Big win there. Big win for Henzo Gracie Jiu-Jitsu Pittsburgh today.
Wow. Wilkins opened up a big cut over the right eyebrow. Coggins.
I think it was just... Wilkins is just considerably bigger and stronger here at 55. Mike Wilkins is a UFC-sized 155er. When you see some of these UFC-sized guys like Benson Henderson or something, that's the size that Mike Wilkins is. Sometimes you look at what weight they weigh in at and then what they look like in the ring, and you are just amazed that much man can fit into that weight class. And that's, you know, one of the reasons he won here, because weight cutting itself is its own art and its own skill.
Absolutely. I can't wait to get a look at this instant replay. What an amazing finish here by Wilkins. I've never seen Mike Wilkins pull this before. I mean, he is just going crazy with his strikes.
Yeah, I think the thing is Wilkins' strikes look better than we've ever seen them.
I think he's finally starting to gain some confidence in those strikes.
You know, he was a wrestler who adapted himself to jiu-jitsu and definitely found a niche there. But I think now he's bringing striking to bear. His pro career looks like it's taking off. I mean, he could be at higher levels any day now, any time.
Just unrelenting in his ground and pound after he dropped Coggins. Really, really impressive finish. You know, I thought by the look of Coggins' right foot pushing on the hips, that might have constituted an intelligent defense to the referee, but I suppose I am wrong. Let's send it over to our ring announcer, Dan Bogan, for the official decision.
At 2 minutes and 10 seconds of round one, your winner by KO due to strikes, fighting out of the blue corner. This one's for the Wilkins Army, Mike Wilkins! To you, Katie.
Wow. Wow. What an
Hi, how are you?
What an incredible win. Can you tell us a little bit about what was going on in your mind during the first part of that fight?
Well, yeah, first came out with a lot of pressure on me tonight, you know. Unfortunately, a good friend of mine, Dominic Mazzotta, his fight got canceled. But his misfortune was kind of like a good thing for me, because I got to step up to be the main event. In that first round, I just wanted to put some of my new tools to work. Everybody who's seen me fight, they know me as a grappler, not a striker. So I kind of wanted to prove to myself that I can strike.
I believe you did. Is there anyone you'd like to thank tonight?
Yeah, first off, I want to shout out Henzo Gracie, Pittsburgh, Stout Training Pittsburgh, Yinzer Scrap Pack, all my training partners, my sponsors. Hey, everybody, come hang out with me down Gus's in Lawrenceville. Shout out to Soltis Design for making my shorts, Pit First Nutrition for giving me the supplements that I need to go hit two-a-days. Also, shout out to Katie Jones. But lastly, I want to wish a happy birthday to my sister, Alexis. This one's for you.
Thank you. Congratulations. Let's hear it for him, everyone.
Okay, Mike, awesome. You fought for Gladiators of the Cage now, three times or something?
Three.
What do you think? You ready for a title shot now?
Yeah, I think I'm the man for the job.
Title?
Yeah, I think I'm the man for the job. Come in here, 3-0, 155.
What do you people think? It's you think Mike's ears. Ready for the title? 155 title! Let me hear it, come on! March, brother.
Thank you very much, right. Thank you.
Thank you.
And thanks Gladiator of the Cage for putting on these shows down here so close to my house, so that way all you guys can pack it and we kill it just like we did tonight. Thanks, everybody.
March, title fight for Mike Wilkins.
Ladies and gentlemen, Robert Joseph and your winner of the main event, Mike Wilkins! Gladiators of the Cage, thanks you for coming out this evening. Please travel safely. Do not forget our after parties at McFadden's. Vince Brasco, you're in for trouble. Thank you for supporting local MMA. Have a Merry Christmas. Drive safely. We'll see you in March. Good night. God bless.
It's time now tonight to recognize our winner for submission of the night, Jessica Zomchik, with a slick and deep armbar.
Yeah, this armbar is really nice. The thing is, she knew she was better at submissions. She jumped guard and went right to it.
Absolutely, no grinding involved, no hesitation, just took the arm and bent it way far backwards.
Very nice form there, perfect. Knees squeezed together. Hips popped out. Just really an excellent demonstration of an armbar from guard.
Not a tough decision at all. That was the submission of the night. Now on to our knockout of the night, Dan Kakuta in his pro debut. Beautiful knee to the side of the face.
Once again, perfect technique. Skip side knee to the face, kind of jumped out with the left foot, brought the knee in at a great angle to hit the jaw. I mean, just clobbered him there. Like, perfect, perfect execution.
All right, that's it for us, folks. From Gladiators of the Cage, North Shore Rise to Power 7, I'm Grant Berger, and with me is...
Mike Willis.
Thank you very much for tuning in, and we will see you on the next one.